What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Alex. Make sure y'all like and make sure y'all subscribe. And here I want to talk about what Lil Duval mentioned as far as if you're a man and you're 30 or above, you shouldn't have roommates. First of all, things get very interesting when people get famous, because when Lil Duval, before he blew up, he was roommates with Mike Epps. He was well over 30 when he was roommates with Mike Epps. And I remember Kevin Hart, when he was talking about before he blew up, how he was sleeping on people's couches and all types of stuff. So for someone like Lil Duval, who got it out the mud, and it took him until midlife to get it out of that mud, to then come out on a national platform during a pandemic and shame men for having roommates because it's not masculine, was just really corny to me. Charlamagne and Envy doing it didn't surprise me that much, because that's just girls throwing shade. Like, that's what they do. But it coming from Lil Duval was a little bit like, what? Especially because of the situation, is because it's like, you had roommates. And then it turned into, of course, what I knew it was going to turn into, which is, now we're going to shame men who have roommates, because if you're a man, you should have all this money, right? Okay, so now you have people calling in. Of course, you get the ladies, they're going to call in, and they're going to say, yeah, man, these are the guys that I've dealt with in their 30s who have roommates. Guys, look, you think women don't have roommates? That's a lot. Listen, not only do they have roommates, they live with their parents a lot of the times you come and meet them. But they out here talking about dudes who have roommates. And y'all got to realize, even if y'all was listening to the responses on the Breakfast Club of what they were saying about the dudes who have roommates, a lot of their frustration was because they didn't have anywhere to have sex, or they didn't have anywhere to potentially move into, aka they homosexuals, and they were looking for someone's house to move into, and that's why they were upset that they had roommates. They saying shit like sharing bathrooms and stuff like that. Guys, listen, I used to tell dudes all the time, if you're not in a relationship, or you're not married, okay, or you're not even pointing in that trajectory, the smartest thing you can do is have a roommate. Because when so I left my mom at 18, went out on my own, went to college, I wanted to get in-state tuition, so I lived with my friends for a little bit, then I got my own place. I got my own place when I was at the age of 21, okay, that was my first time ever living on my own. What's the benefits of living on your own? Will it make access to women easier? Yeah. Is it dope to be able to do what you want to do when you want to do it, play your music, scratch your balls? Yeah. But it's expensive as all hell. And when you think about the amount of money that you're saving by having a roommate, especially considering the fact that the majority of men, because of how we are as men, we can get along with each other. We're not going to kill each other living together. You know what I'm saying? If you hustling, you're not even going to be in a house like that. So what's it matter? The amount of money you can save, think about it, guys. If you live on your own, you in a big metropolitan city, you're going to be paying anywhere from probably like, really, I'm being nice here, $800 to like $1,600 for one bedroom. I'm being nice here, right? If you got a roommate, you're cutting that in half. That's half that you can save. That's half that you can invest. That's half that you can put into so much other stuff. And you're going to put it into a place that you rent, not own. You could be saving to buy, but you're going to put it into a place that you rent, not own. You could be saving for your business, but you're going to put it in a place that you rent, not own, so that women and girly niggas like Charlamagne and Envy and stuff can give you validation. This is why I tell you guys, never seek outward invalidation. Whatever the world's telling you to do is usually not what you should do. The world's going to tell you, spend all your money to show you got money, so you can look high value and all that other nonsense. Listen, every man I've known who's had roommates or anything like that at any point in his past, like, they're eating right now. They own properties. They started businesses. Like, they're eating right now. And most of the people who just ran out and got their own spot, they aren't doing so well, because they always have to work consistently all the time to keep paying for this place that they'll never own. They get themselves stuck in a debt trap. I know some people who've been renting the same place for 20 years. You done paid for it 3 times and they're still there. So do I think in your 30s that you should? I think you should, as long as you're going to have a plan in place and you're moving towards something, I don't see the issue. I mean, and what type of place are you even living? I mean, you could be roommates and you in a penthouse. You could be roommates and y'all have a townhouse. So there's so many different variables to that. But I just think everything is so built around, like, to me nowadays, everything is so built around money. And you got to have this or you should have that. Like, who's to say you're not a solid dude because you have a roommate? Because you feel like because someone's 30, they shouldn't have one. You're going to look past everything else. Like, to me, we just get way too stuck on intangible stuff. Like, it has nothing to do with how good of a person they are, their vision, how they're going to treat you. Are they taking you out? None of that. Do you have your own place? Like, that's what we're breaking everything down to. What if you got his own place and he's stomping you out? What if you got his own place, but he's still always at yours? What if you got his own place, but he ain't got no car or job? Like, I don't know. Just to me, it's just funny how people blow up and they get this money and then all they want to do is constantly just talk down on regular people in regular situations. I just think that that's really corny. Listen, at the end of the day, having a roommate as a male or a female is still not being at your mom's crib. It's still not living up under anyone. You still have bills. You still have responsibilities. So it's a step. And like I said, it can help you save and you can flip that into different stuff. So I don't believe anyone, especially men, should allow anyone to make them feel ashamed about that. Do what you do and do what's best for you. So jokes are jokes or whatever the case may be. But like I said, my thoughts on it, do what you do and do what's best for you. I'm Alex and I'm out. Peace.